So you land in England. You're homeless. Can you give us a sense of, and when you say homeless, because a lot of people who are successful, they loosely use that term. They have maybe a couch that they can sleep on. Maybe they have family that says, look, you can crash here for a few days, but this is technically not your home. When you say you are homeless, were you one of the people that we see literally laying on the concrete, cardboard boxes, no bathroom, no shelter, homeless?
Yes.
Wow.
Yes. Yes, and it's basically, I mean, it was very difficult time of my life, Sean, because frankly, I did not care about my life. I cared about what was happening that nobody else cared.
Oh, okay. You're homeless for 6 straight months. How do you transition? Because that's a difficult road. It's a difficult position to be in, especially at such a young age. That can break someone. You just came through war, so thank God you weren't broken there. And now you find yourself in, some would argue, an even worse position, living on the streets. From a purely mental and psychological point of view, how did you not break? And more important, how did you get out of that situation in 6 months? Because there are people who have been homeless for years and can't seem to figure it out.
I think it's that force within us, Sean, that force, God-given intelligence. And maybe, you know, I believe that we all are here for a specific duty. I believe God sent us in here to do some greater service that goes beyond ourselves. Some of us, we discover it early in life. Other people maybe discover it through heart adversity. Other people are discovering maybe somebody close to you dies. Maybe you do it because, you know, you are called to do it. Or maybe you believe in something so strong that you dedicate your life to it. So those 6 months for me were life transforming on so many levels. And reason being, I think it's, I always say, like, change comes to you and service comes to you without you even asking. It just basically, that soul that lives within us has been there before this lifetime. And it knows how to guide you. We just need to listen to it. And I think after I shed all the tears I've ever had, I could not cry anymore. Suddenly I found myself in silence. And it was in that silence that I really heard that calling that I heard when I was a kid to go out there and be the best version I can be and help billion people transform their lives and educate myself, get back on the track, find a job, learn the language, adapt, because my grandparents, they always read books. My grandfather always taught me about books. And my parents taught me, I learned everything about what I need to learn about farming. I learned anything I needed to learn about restaurant business. On top of that, I was a scientist, I was a mathematician, and I literally wanted to learn about life, about discovering the questions of life, the mysteries of life, studying different religions, because I've come from a mixed product religion with a mixed culture, and I wanted to really unlock that human potential in every child, in every adult, so we can create a better future and we can direct the consciousness of humanity and literally take care of what I call it, the sacredness of what we are, life. And unless we really wake up to that, unless we wake up that, you know, we together, we are all passengers in this world, you know? And we pretend like we own something. We pretend we own those borders. We own those countries. We own those religions. We own those things. And we all come naked and we go back naked. And if we really listen to those words and if we really honor what life is about and what everything around us represents, we start to change. An environment for sure changes you. Because, you know, being in London, London has this amazing environment, has this amazing freedom that basically, if you are cold and if you are honest, have integrity, and you love working, you'll break through. And if you don't give yourself excuses, you know, you can find opportunities. It wasn't easy, that for sure. But after 6 months, I got myself into a job. And in the next, I would say 9 years, I worked with no break, no break. And usually my sleeping hours were for 9 years, 4 hours a day, a habit which today follows me. Meaning, wow. I had to work full time because I had to pay for my own education and I had to study full time. So that work and study full time finished when I got my degree at one of the top engineering universities here in London. And by then the war stopped in former Yugoslavia. And the biggest gift I got is the fact that although I lost many members of my family, I did not lose my parents. And basically I flew mom and dad for my graduation in London in 1998. And that for me was like, I don't know, call it miracle of God, call it a miracle. It was a miracle to unite myself with my family after 8 years.
Such a beautiful story. Such a beautiful, well, it's a beautiful ending. The story itself is filled with a lot of trauma. What's up, guys? Thanks for sticking with me to the end of the video. Truly appreciate you. If you like anything you heard here today, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you know anybody that can benefit from this message, feel free to share. Peace and love.